India had just become an independent state, though it was still searching for stability. But there were entrepreneurs eager to explore the world after nearly a decade of war and isolation. They would seize on the opportunities offered by the great international changes occurring in the 1950s. It was indeed in India where Inverni Della Beffa managed to accumulate supplies of Gloriosa superba, an orchid from which they obtained colchicine, a molecule with anti-inflammatory properties especially useful in the treatment of gout.
These years marked a turning point in research as the scientists in Via Ripamonti not only elaborated extracts, but isolated their active ingredients. And there was more. It was at this time that the company began to manufacture and market finished medicines based on the phytotherapeutic ingredients produced in their laboratories.
Welcome to PHYTOCAST, an audio journey of discovery into the realm of medicinal plants as we retrace the history of the world leader in the production of plant extracts. It is the story of 100 years of botanical excellence.
Gloriosa is a climbing plant with a very long stem, which merits such a high-sounding name thanks to the exuberant splendor of its large orange-red flowers. It contains toxic substances, but in the wise words of the sage Paracelsus, the dosage alone makes it so a thing is not a poison.
In fact, when transformed and used correctly, in addition to its anti-inflammatory properties, Gloriosa can yield several other benefits, some of which would be discovered in the years to come. Gloriosa seeds, for example, contain a molecule with important muscle relaxant capabilities. To obtain this active ingredient, however, vast amounts of Gloriosa superba were needed, of which only a small part was used.
To cut down this wastage, a new fermentation process was developed in Via Ripamonti. Working on another molecule, far more plentiful in the plant from which the gout medication is derived, they found they could also obtain the active ingredient able to relax muscle tissue. By eliminating this waste, they were able to unlock Gloriosa's full potential.
Here, then, is one of the distinctive features of the company that would become Indana. The production of botanical derivatives is associated with the protection of the natural environment and its resources. And let's not forget that over 120 plant species are processed, 40% of which grow spontaneously, and 60% are cultivated. The sustainable and ethical exploitation of nature is a fundamental requirement of the brand. This mission goes beyond the procurement of raw materials to involve the communities that cultivate and harvest them.
For many years, Indena has been following a precise way of operating. When deciding to use a specific plant in a particular country, an agreement is reached with the authorities on a fair percentage of potential sales of the active ingredient. That percentage is then distributed within the local communities. By sharing the profits derived from the plants with the communities that are blessed by this rich biodiversity, we are guaranteeing and safeguarding our natural heritage.
PHYTOCAST, the story of 100 years of botanical excellence.